Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over different slide animations inside of Microsoft PowerPoint. We've also provided a sample file for you to follow along with today, and feel free to use that as a template for anything you would like to use. You can customize it to whatever your needs are. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So let me show you what the final product is going to be. If I hit the down arrow in my slideshow, you can see that I am moving to each one of these Microsoft products. And I'm displaying different information about that product in my slideshow. So that's where we're going today. So if I go to File, I can select a blank presentation, and that's how I would like to start. But when I bring up a blank presentation, my default is set to have these two text boxes on there. If I click inside the text box, I'm able to change the text that's in there. But what I would like to do is select the text box. So if I hover my mouse up here until it turns into this cross, I can click on the rectangle of the text box, and then I can hit delete. But if I wait until the mouse is like an eye like this and I click in there, then I can edit whatever text I have in there. But I really just want to select the text box, so I'm going to hit delete again. And let's close this design ideas window so that we have more space to work with. So let's go back to the original one that we are going to copy today. And let's just look at the slide that's right here. You can see that I have four rectangles on here. I have four icons on here, so these are pictures. And I also have a text box on every page with the link that I would like to go to on our website. So let's put all of those together. I'm going to go back to our new presentation, and I'm going to go up to Insert and go to Shapes and select a rectangle. And I would like to start drawing that rectangle right around here, maybe almost halfway down the page. And once I've drawn a rectangle, you can see that the shape format ribbon comes up. So what I would like to do first is get rid of the shape outline and change that to no outline. Then I would like to go to shape effects, and I'd like to go to shadow. And I would like to have a top shadow right here. And now you can sort of see how it looks a little smoky at the top of this. Next, I would like to go back to insert and go down to pictures. And I'd like to insert a picture from my device, and I'm looking for the PowerPoint icon. Now, the PowerPoint icon comes in really large. If I hover down here, you can see I get a two-sided arrow. And if I click and drag to the top left, I can make this icon a lot smaller. So let's move that right here to the center of our rectangle. And I can find the center of our rectangle if I select here and see where that selection dot is, and I'm just going to click on the icon again and move it over in this general direction. But you can see that a line is showing up in PowerPoint, so I know that that is centered. Next, I want to turn this rectangle that we put on here into one of these colors in the icon itself, and I would like an exact match of that color. So let's see how to do that. I'm going to select the rectangle and go up here to the fill colors. And I'm going to pick the eyedropper. And then I would like this color right here on the icon. So I'm just going to click it, and you can see that the rectangle color became the same color as this quadrant inside of the PowerPoint icon. So you can now see how I created the first PowerPoint page that we are going to use. So next, I'm going to select this rectangle. And we're going to do this process all over again four times for each one of the Microsoft products. So I'm going to copy with Control C and then paste with Control V an exact copy of this rectangle, and I'm going to line it up with the existing one. Then I'm going to pick the middle selection, hold my left mouse button down, and drag down. I want to drag down about a quarter of the way. And then next I'm going to go to Insert, Pictures, from this device, and this time I want the word icon. I'll go down here, click and drag to the top left, and make the icon a lot smaller. And then I'm going to drag this icon next to the PowerPoint one to see how the sizes relate to each other. So this one could be a tiny bit bigger. And then I'm going to click and drag the icon right here. Do you see how that middle line is appearing again? Now I know my icons are lined up. So if I select the rectangle and I go back to fill color and I go back to the eyedropper, this time I'm going to pick the second color down on the word icon. And then I'm done with that one. The rectangle is already chosen for me, so Control C, Control V, line it up, pull it down, go to Insert, Pictures, this device, and you can guess what one we're doing this time. Let's do Excel. Make the Excel icon smaller, sizes up next to the word icon, bring it to the middle of the rectangle, select the rectangle, select the fill color, and get the eyedropper. And let's pick this green over here near the X. And then finally, our last one, Control C, Control V, reposition, make it smaller, go to Insert, Pictures, this device, and select Access. Resize the icon, move it down here, choose the rectangle, go up to color, choose the eyedropper, and let's get this red down here. So there you go. Those are our rectangles and our icons. And we are going to use this for the template of the next slide. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. So I'm going to right click here and go to duplicate slide. And now let's think about how the second slide should look. If I click on the top PowerPoint one and I select the middle of the rectangle and drag up, and then I'm going to select PowerPoint icon and drag up. Now I have some space to write what I want to write for PowerPoint. So then I'm going to duplicate this slide because I want that change on the next slide. And this time I'm going to make the word one bigger and drag the word icon up to the top. Right click, duplicate slide, same for the green, move the icon, right click, duplicate slide, same for the red. Now it's up to you if you would like a final screen at the end of this. I chose not to put one there, but you are more than welcome to duplicate this slide or maybe put in a blank slide at the end and maybe give your main website or just whatever other information you would like to give someone. Okay, so now let's go into the specific data for each slide. If we go to the top slide, this slide had our logo on it. So I'm going to go to Insert, Pictures, from this device, and I'm going to select our logo. And you can see it's here in the middle of the screen. It's really small, so I'm just going to click and drag, and then I'm going to drag the icon to make it look bigger. For the PowerPoint slide, I'm going to go to Insert a text box, and I'm going to draw that text box all the way across the rectangle. And I'll make it a little wider on this side by clicking when I have the double-headed arrow and just dragging to the left. And why did I make it this large? Because when I go up here and I hit center, it will be in the very center of my presentation. So I'm going to select the text box and go up here to choose white and bold because I want that to be the text color for this slide. And I'm going to paste in the link of that part of our website where we have the PowerPoint files. And you may have to drag the text box a little bit to position it correctly. So next I'm going to copy the already formatted text box that's in the format that I would really like. And I'm going to click on the Microsoft Word one and I'm going to paste it as well. And I'll just move it down a little bit and I'm going to highlight what's already in there and paste my new web page that I would like this to go to. And then I'm going to copy this, paste it in Excel. And our whole website has to do with Excel, so I'm just going to paste our main blog in here. And then I'm going to copy and paste this down here, reposition it, and paste in our Access webpage. So now that looks pretty complete, but there's one more thing we need to do. I've selected the first slide, but if I hold down Shift and click on all these other slides, I can select them all at once. And I'm going to go up to Transitions and go to Morph. And you can kind of get a preview of what Morph is going to look like. Okay, so we're ready. If I go to Slideshow, I can click this button to view the slideshow from the beginning, or I can click this button down here and I can view the slideshow this way as well. So let's just click this one And you can see how that sort of faded onto the screen. That's the morphing transition. So if I click the button down, it's animated. And that's the value of the morph transition. So if I click down again, I can see my information about Word, Excel, and Access. Click the down arrow one more time, I'll see it's the end of my slideshow, and I can click the down arrow one more time to go back to PowerPoint. So hopefully that gives you a good idea of some transitions and animations you can use in PowerPoint that you may not have thought of before. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. And thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.